professor from WID Solapur. In this lecture, I am going to discuss about the segmentation in operating system. Now, these are the learning objectives of this lecture. At the end of this video, the student should be able to describe drawbacks of paging, then the segmentation mechanism, and he should be able to convert logical addresses into the physical address. Now, as we all know, paging is a memory management scheme by which a computer stores or retrieves data from secondary storage to the main memory. Because during process execution, the CPU is getting data from this main memory and data is now coming from the secondary memory. Now, in the paging, we are dividing this entire secondary memory into equal size partitions. And each partition is normally called as a page. After that, the memory manager, or we also call this as a MMU, is dividing the physical address space into the equal pieces, that is called the frame here. Paging, we are finding these kind of drawbacks here. If you choose the large size page during the paging mechanism, so it is normally is going to carry the problem of internal fragmentation. That is, lot of space is remaining unused here and we are going to lose the memory size. Secondly, if I make a page size very small here, it is found that the overheads in this page handling is very high, and so that this mechanism become inefficient. Then this one more drawback is coming here. Suppose you are having a process divided into different pages, and suppose the CPU finishes a process on first page and is going to find out the second page now, but suppose the page 2 is not available in the RAM, then at that time the process is not completed, or it is halted, is called as a segment. Now, segmentation is very important here, and suppose if we keep user's point of view into mind here, so it is found that it is beneficial to split the program into small pieces. And it is found that a program normally carries different types of requirements here. So I am listing some of the requirements here. So we have got a main program, then we handle some procedures or some functions, we handle some objects, we handle variables locally and globally, we also handle stack, we also handle some data blocks here which are common to number of codes there. So from user's point of perspective, if you see that the process or program is split into these different requirements here. I got stack, I got data, I got function, we find subroutines, and we get symbol tables here. If we handle all these blocks separately, it is beneficial. So in segmentation, as we know, programs are stored in the secondary memory. So segmentation is a mechanism through which I am going to divide the secondary memory in different pieces here. We normally call them as we seen in the previous diagram here, the different segments are having different sizes here. So that in the segmentation, we are going to make partition of the secondary memory of different sizes here, which mean that we are going to find out the different segments in secondary memory at different locations having different sizes there. Now, when we bring this segment here for the processing in the main memory, then you have to make sure that there should be continuous memory allocation for this segment into the main memory. Suppose if we don't find enough memory size in the main memory to accommodate this segment here, in that case it is not possible to transfer a segment from secondary memory back into the main memory. Process, I'm dividing that in 5 different segments here, namely S1 to S5, and I'm storing that segment in the hard disk here, that is a secondary memory, in this given way here. S5 is stored in the beginning, the address is starting from this 1000 here, then S2 is stored from 1300 here, S4 is stored from 1600, and so on here. Now these process segments are stored at different locations. Now the numbers on this left hand side is normally called as a logical address, because that is pointing to the secondary memory here. This also can be called as the base address here. So during segmentation, we require the location of this segment here in the secondary memory. Now, how to use the segment here? So when I want to use a segmentation here, so we can name this segment here with the help of a logical address here. For example, I want to suppose call a segment number 5. So we know that the segment 5 is starting from 1000 here. And we know here also the segment number 2 is starting from 1300, which means that the segment 5 has a length of 300 here. So we can see here, I can call the segment here by a logical address here, that is a combination of the base address and the length of the segment here. So in the case of segment number 5, we get the base address as 1000 here and the length is coming as 300 here. Now when you want to execute a process, so we use a segment for that process definition here. So in a RAM we are going to find out different segments there. So operating system is going to manage one table, is normally called as a segment table here, which are having these kind of entries. It is having two columns here. In one column we store the base address of the segment here, and the second column carries the length of the given segment here. Whereas we also are going to have one more column, and we are going to store this block here or this segment in the RAM, and we name these segments as either S1, S2, S3 and so on here. So in my example, the S1 is stored from in the memory here, that is in the RAM, whose base address in the secondary memory is starting from 1700 and it is having the length of 300 here. Now actually, how to make sure that the address, because we know here, whenever CPU is generating the address for access of data here, it's in secondary memory, and we have to bring that data from the secondary memory back into the main memory here. Now we know here, logic address having two components, that is base address, and second we call this as a offset here. So for example, CPU want to read some instruction in suppose segment number 1. So we have to confirm that I must first pointing to the base address of the given segment S1, and after that the offset address should be such that it should be lying in the permissible range of the segment area here. That is, the offset address should not be more than the length of the given segment here. So this diagram is showing me that kind of mechanism. That is, whenever CPU want to access some instruction here, he generates logical address here. So first I will point out the base address, that is in the secondary memory, and we are going to have some offset here. Now we are going to compare this offset with the length of the given segment here. Suppose offset is less than the given length of segment, then it is called to be a legal reading from the given main memory here. Suppose the offset is greater than the length of the segment here, it is going to create the error. It is normally called a trap. So we have to avoid this condition. So when I get a trap, so CPU is prevented to read that location in the given segmentation here. Now in this segmentation, the problems we find in the paging mechanism is not at all available in this one here. That is, we know here we are not going to get the problem such as the page fault here, because the page may not be there in memory sometimes here, as we store this entire segment together, so we never get such difficulties here. Then segmentation makes a possible use of separate memory areas for stack, code and data, so it becomes modular. So because of this modularity of this handling here, the object-oriented programming is quite possible here. And moreover, the segmentation is providing me a protection here. Now again, question comes, how we are going to provide protection with the help of this segmentation here. Now this example, I am giving a simple example here. So we get segment table as mentioned here. We store two segments here. The first column shows the base address here. The second shows you the length here. And currently, CPU generates some addresses that is called logical address here, that is 110 and 2550 here. Suppose in this example, the first digit in the LA, suppose that indicates the page, the segment number here. That is, in the first example, LA is 110, means 1 indicates the segment number, and remaining part 10 indicates the offset here. In the second example, it is 2550 here. So the 2 number indicates the segment number, and 550 is going to indicate the offset here. So we know here, in the segment here, CPU generates the address, suppose 110 here. So we are going to first look after the segment 1, and we are going to compare the offset and the length of segment here. Now in this example, the offset is 10 and the length of segment is 14 here. So 14 is more than 10, so it is a legal reading here. So CPU can read a location, that is sum of this base address plus the offset here, that becomes 2310. In second example, LA is 2550 here. That is, we are going to access the second segment here, and the offset is 550, which is more than the length of segment here, which means that you are trying to read a location which is not a part of current segment here. So at that moment, the system create one alert here, that is called a trap, and we prevent the CPU to read that location which is not a part of current segment here. In this way, we are going to provide segment protections in the given segmentation there. Friends, I use these books to provide this information to you. Thank you very much for